facing a catastrophic situation. The town calls on sewer diver Rick Simon, AKA Filthy Ricky.
We can already tell that the water is going to be pretty low visibility, so we're going to move very slowly, walking up this pipe, just being very careful with what we're touching and what we're feeling.
Although the water Rick will be swimming in shouldn't have toxins, there's still the risk that larger objects could harm him.
As far as safety goes, let's just really be careful that no one gets stuck with anything. When umbilicals are coming back, just look at them as you're coiling. In this area, what we're really worried most about today is broken glass and hypodermic needles in the water. So we want to be careful we don't get stuck or poke with anything.
Typically, the water flowing from a nearby treatment plant creates frothing white rapids where it enters the Sound through underwater pipes here. The still surface suggests a significant blockage at some unknown point further up the line. It's Rick's job to clear out the blockage. There are several junction points that could contain the problem. To find out, Rick needs to swim as far as 400 yards up the dark and twisting pipes, inspecting them one by one.
All right, does anyone have any questions about what has to get done? You guys good?
So let's suit up. So the next step is we're gonna go for a swim.
A dry suit is sealed from external elements, providing much needed protection from the sewer's contaminants.
We dive in a lot of different wet substances, not just water. It could be paper pulp, could be human waste, could be grease, could be animal waste.
Although Rick will be alone in the pipes, his onshore team has his back, specifically his father, Eric, who will serve as his dive tender.
The tender's job is to help the diver from the surface. He's the one who's handling the diver's umbilical in and out of the water.
Eric is suiting up so that he can dive in after Rick if he gets into trouble.
I've been diving quite a while. It's a dangerous occupation. You know, people have gotten killed, but we're very safe about it, and hopefully we'll live to tell another tale.
Unlike scuba divers that use lightweight oxygen tanks made from aluminum, sewage divers wear tanks made from galvanized steel. They weigh over 150 pounds. The heavier material prevents debris from puncturing the oxygen tank.
We don't know exactly what the plan is yet until we can find out what's down there. So the first step to solving the problem is to find out what's there and what's going on. It's very exciting to not know what's going on because we're going to be able to go up the pipe and figure it out. So it's always fun solving a new problem and seeing what's there and getting more information.
Roger, in the water.
Copy.
As Rick enters the pipe, he sees something indicating the situation is far worse than expected. Maggots feed on waste and decay. Their presence here could indicate the water entering the Sound may be cross-contaminated.
We got a serious problem down here. We got a bomb here. This is a critical pipe.
If this pipe backs up, the water has to go somewhere, and that somewhere is into the street.
Roger, at the entrance, 2 feet of rocks and debris.
The rocks are also a bad sign.
Right when I get into the pipe, there's already a 2-foot pile of rock and debris. This pipe works with gravity, so as the water flows, it should push all those rocks out, but it's not. It's backing up into the streets. If these rocks pile up long enough, we're gonna have a serious blockage.
Rick swims further into the outflow, hoping to find the source of the blockage.
Roger, a square junction pipe on a round pipe.
Man, there's a ton of hinges on a round pipe.
It's crucial for Rick to keep in constant communication with his dive tender and father, Eric, who keeps track of the conditions and Rick's location, just in case they need to return to it later.
To know the distance into the pipe we are, my umbilical is marked every 10 foot. So if I find something, I'm gonna ask topside to take a mark.
As Rick swims further into the pipe, he finds more signs of a severe blockage.
Roger, is that 4 feet of sand? Roger.
The deeper I penetrate into the pipe, the more debris I'm seeing. 2, 3, 4 feet high. That means the water in here isn't moving, at least from this point forward. How far the blockage is, nobody knows.
Whoa, we got a wheelbarrow down here. And it looks like an old backpack. So the kid really didn't want to do his homework.
Roger, let me know.
Rick is now over 300 feet in to the pipe. Rick finds the blockage in a manhole shaft. There's so much debris, he can't break through it. With the clog located, Rick makes his way back to the surface to regroup with the rest of the team.
Sorry.
Woo.
Oh, you're good.
What was our distance?
350 was the furthest.
So that manhole is in the section before the 90.
And we were expecting it
to be at the 90, but it's not. It's in the pipe section before the end.
Around 350 feet in, the outflow pipe makes a 90-degree turn going from horizontal to vertical. Right before this point is where the blockage is.
So you come up and in there, and there's a bunch of rocks and debris, which is what we expected. And then there's, back where I said, there's a garbage can, and there's a blanket or a tarp. It's probably like a canvas drop cloth or something like.
Oysters too, you said?
Oysters, yeah. The whole walls are covered with oysters. On both sides. You want me to bring you home some?
Yeah, 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 yeah. Good eating.
Yeah.
That's also right.
Yeah.
They grow good in dirty water.
Good filtration, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, good comps.
Comps, that's good. Perfect.
Union break.
Union break. Can I get an unzip, Mr. Jim?
Yep.
Because it's located at the end of the horizontal pipe, Rick theorizes the blockage is the result of debris carried from the treatment plant that is piled up over time after traveling down the vertical shaft.
Where you already have a buildup now, more debris will start accumulating over time. So if we're able to get rid of that debris, then we're able to stop the problem from being a bigger issue. So the next step will be come up with a plan to actually remove the sediment and the debris.
Rick reviews the charts of this section of sewer and locates an access point he believes will allow the team to remove the blockage.
So we're gonna enter the water from this chamber here. And we're gonna go down and start sucking the sand out of this main chamber.
To clean out the blockage, Rick will employ an industrial vacuum truck, which operates at about 4,000 CFM, or cubic feet per minute. That's about 40 times stronger than the average household vacuum cleaner. And it's powerful enough to rip up your floorboards.
So it's about 17 feet to the water.
Rick's father, Eric, will join him on the second dive to help man the vacuum.
You can see all the garbage and debris I'm gonna have to be wading through to get up into the pipe. Looks nasty.
But first, they have to get down there.